Good afternoon, children. Today we are going to start a new chapter, comparing quantities. And in this chapter, we will today only discuss about the introductory part. The first point is ratio, and second one is percent. What do you mean by ratio? Ratio means this is the relation between two quantities. So here we are going to compare these two. So when we are presenting this comparison in the simplest form or in lowest term, that is called ratio. Suppose in your class you have given that ratio of the boys and girls. Is let it be boys is to girls, the ratio of boys is to girls, that is equal to, let's consider it is 5:4. Okay, now suppose you have asked what is the percentage of boys in the class. Suppose you have asked that percentage of boys what you will do. How many you are taking? First one is 5. What is the total? Total is equal to 9. So into 100%. Whatever you are getting, that is the answer. That is 500 by 9. And if you are changing this one in decimal or in mixed fraction, that is enough. So here you have to present this one in percentage. So ratio you can convert. How? You will go for the total. Okay. And how much out of 9, 5 is boys. So how out of 100, how many it will be? That means it will be 100 time of that one. Okay. So for your understanding, I am taking one question from the try this of your book, page number 119. You all can go through the question. As per the question, I have present the data here that 50% parents are there who don't give any more time to their children, and then 30% parents are there who help for half an hour to 1.5 hours. And the rest 20% they help for more than half, 1.5 hours. Okay, so here in first bit you have asked how many parents were surveyed. So here one clue has been given that 30% parents they give, that is the number of parents, there were 90 parents who help for 1/2 hour to 1/2 hour. That means that 90 parents is equal to, that is equal to, that is equal to 30%. They give the time 1.5 to 1/2 hour. So here from that we can find out the total percentage. So as per the question, 30% is equal to 90. So 1% equal to what we will do? 90/30. Then 100% equal to how much you will get? 90 × 100/30. So let's cancel. It is 3. So total number of parents you are getting, that is equal to 300. So here in first bit we can write our answer is for the first bit. Okay, let me write it here. In first bit you have asked how many parents were surveyed. So parents were surveyed. Is equal to 300. So first bit is over. Let's come to the second bit. Here you have asked how many said that they don't help or they didn't help. Okay, how many? It is 50% of what? Of the total. So total number of parents has been given, we have found out it is 300. So 50% don't help. So what we will get the answer in the second bit? As per the question here, that 50% parents did not help. Okay, that is equal to how much? 50% of what? Of 300. So that is equal to 50/100 × 300. Okay, so let's cancel. What we are getting, it is 150. So in second bit my answer will be 150 parents did not help their child. Okay, let's come to the third bit of this question. In third bit you have asked how many said that they helped for more than 1.5 hour. So how many? As per the question it is 20%. So 20% parents, this is the third bit, 20% parents helped for more than 1.5 hour. So here 20% of the total parents is equal to 300. Already we have got it, that is 300. So that much is equal to 20 by 100 into 300. So let's cancel. How much we are getting? 60. So here in the last bit our answer will be 60 parents helped for more than 1 whole 1/2 hour. This is the answer. Okay, so next question I have selected from the book. This is question number 5. You all just go through the question. The question is, if Chamily had rupees 600 left after spending 75% of her money, how much did she have in the beginning? So what you have to find out here in this question, here you have to find out the total money she had earlier. Okay, so how much she has spent? She has spent 75%. So here we can write that she spent 75%. Okay, that means the total money was, total money with her is equal to how much? That is equal to 100%. And now remaining, the left of her amount is equal to 600. That is by rupees. So by percent, how much it will be? So by percent, money left with her by percent is equal to how much? 100% minus 75%. So how much you are getting? 25%. So according to the question, 25% is equal to 600. So we can write that 25% is equal to 600. Now, if I am presenting this one in ratio, what I can write? 25% is 25 by 100, that is equal to, left over is 600. I don't know on what. What is the total money? So the total money, that is equal to, I have considered that that amount is equal to x. So if I am doing the cross multiplication, what I will get? Tell me, it is 25x is equal to 100 into 600. Okay, so x is equal to how much? 100 into 600 divided by 25. So let's cancel. What we are getting? It is 4. So after cancellation, we are getting 2400. So in answer, what we can write? Our answer will be that total money equal to total money she had is equal to how much? Rupees 2400. So this is the answer of this question. I hope you can solve all the question of this exercise. So let's try.